I greet you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Today I want to talk about marriage, 12 tips how to build a strong marriage. How to build your strong marriage. Whatever we are doing is based in scriptures. So it's 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 1. It says, "Wife, likewise, be submissive to your own husbands, that even if some do not obey the word, they will, without a word, may be won by the conduct of their wife. When they observe your chaste conduct accompanied by fear, do not let your adornment be merely outward, arranging hair or wearing gold and putting on fine apparels. Rather, let it be hidden, person of the heart, with incorruptible beauty of a general, quiet spirit, which is very precious in the sight of God. For in this manner, in former times, the holy woman who trusted in God also adorned themselves, being submissive to their own husbands, as Sarah obeyed Abraham, and calling Lot, whom daughters, daughters, you are, if you do good, and are not afraid of the any terror." It says, 7th verse, "Husband, likewise, dwell with them with understanding. Give honor to the wife as to weaker vessel, and being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayers may not be hindered." So you hear what it says. It's involving all of us, a man and a woman. You have got your portion to play. As long as you are stubborn, if you don't play your role in marriage, it's going to cause problem. And if your marriage, if you don't do it best through the scriptures or under Christ, because marriage represents Christ. We are married to Christ, everybody. So when Christ looks at marriage, he looks at his church. So we are an example to Christ. We represent Christ in marriage. Mommy, you represent Christ in your marriage. Father, you represent Christ. So I've got 12 tips here to build your strong marriage. Huh? Number one, pride. If you remove pride in your marriage, a lot of people, they've got a pride that if you don't listen to your husband, you say, "I'm beautiful, I'm educated," those things. It is because of pride. If you have pride, you have such things where, although you divorce your husband, but you want to be married too. A man will say to your wife, "You are not educated. I'm educated. You are from rural area." That's a pride. That's a pride. If you remove pride, drop your pride. Jesus loves you. If you remove your pride, stop praising yourself in marriage. Stop praising yourself. That's too much pride. Your marriage will not work if you don't remove pride. If you have pride, you are unteachable. You will say, "You can't tell me what to do. I'm the husband of this house." But God said, He said in the Eden, He saw that Adam was lonely. He gave him a helper who is evil. So your wife is a helper. She has got a contribution in each and every step you take. So when you say you want to be married, you are not individual. You are with your wife. You are with your husband. So you are not alone. So remove pride. If you have pride in marriage, you are unteachable. You don't even listen because you say you know everything, or you have money. Oh yes, you have money, you reduce each other. You come from poor family. You are not educated, which is bad in marriage. It's not allowed. It's not allowed to rules of marriage. And if you have good pride, you are it's very difficult to cancel you, because you will say you know everything. No one will know everything. Even a president have got a presidential advisor. He have got presidential advisors. So watch your speech, watch the way you talk. Drop your pride. Remove your pride. If you have pride, your marriage will not work. Number two, it's money. In money, 75% people, they are being divorced. In money, you must be transparent. Don't steal to each other. Don't lie to each other. You have a secret account. In secret accounts, you hide money, you take such money, you put aside, you take such money, you put aside. You send money to your parents without the knowledge of your wife, without the knowledge of your husband, which is bad. And you don't even confess that you used to steal money to your husband. You used to steal money to your husband, to your wife, although you say, I'm the one who is waiting for this money. You see, money is a problem, it's the root of all evil. 1 Timothy 6 verse 10, it says so. So remember about money. Money, a lot of people, they are being separated because of money. There is no transparency in money. A husband will just say, this is my money. You will have your own account. A wife, she will have her own account. And the husband will have her own account. Secret accounts. It is for you all. It doesn't matter. Your husband is not working. Your wife is not working. It doesn't matter. You are one thing. Are you married before money? Money is a blessing from God. It comes today, tomorrow it goes. You see, it's like today it's sunny, tomorrow it's cloudy. The other day it's sunny. You see? And the other day it's raining, the other day there's a storm. So life is like that. So that is perishable thing. So that is perishable thing. Don't focus on perishable things. Don't focus on that. And don't keep secrets of mine in your marriage. Be open, whatever you want to do. Money must be, you must know how much your husband is earning, your wife is earning. You change your character because you are now working as a wife. You are now getting more money than your husband. It's a problem. Number three, same goals, family plan, how to construct your family. You must have same goals, not different. Mommy is saying this, father is saying this. You see now, you must have same goals. Same goals. Don't go in a different ways. Same goals, same mind. Support each other in all of those goals. Although husband, you are the head of the house, you have a final say, but a point is a point somewhere. Effects are stubborn. You know effects are stubborn. If it is a fact, it's a fact. So you must have the same goals. Mother, you saying, I want to buy a car. The wife said, let us buy a stand. You must have same mind. Support each other. Yes, support each other. Support each other. And you must express your feelings. in those goals. Don't swallow everything. In marriage, it's bad. If you swallow everything, you kill yourself. You kill yourself. Make intimacy open for everything. You see, make intimacy. You must not have a secret. What your husband does not know, your wife does not know, secrets. Why do you have secrets? You must have intimacy. Intimacy. Everything must be open. Everything must be open in your marriage. Let it be open. You mustn't have a secret, like what I was talking about, secret account. You see, secret family, you do not tell your wife that you've got a child there. Or a wife, you do not tell your husband that you have a child also, which is bad. You must not have a secret. You must have an intimacy. Intimacy, everything must be public between you and your husband. Everything must be open to each other. Number five, kiss each other. Yes, we are saying kiss each other. There are people who are too holy. I will open a verse here. There are two people who are too holy. How can you talk about that in the word of God? We just want to hear Christ. Just to preach. How can you talk about kiss each other, romance each other? Where do you get it? I'll go there. As usual. 1 Corinthians 7, verse 2. Nevertheless, because of sexual immorality, let each man have his own wife, and let each woman have her own husband. Let a husband render to his wife the affection, you remember, you hear this, the affection to her, and likewise also the wife to her husband. The wife does not have authority over her own body. What does that, this mean? Your wife, you don't have the authority to your body, but the husband does have. A husband does have the authority to your body, and likewise, the husband does not have authority over his own body, and the wife does. A wife, so which means you, as a wife, you don't have authority to your body, but the owner of your body is your husband. So why you say, no, don't touch me there, don't touch me there, don't touch me there? If you fail to do that, when did you last kiss your husband? Always it's no, 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 I don't like this. If you fail to do that, who is going to please your husband? Like sexuality, you know, a lot of people, they don't want to talk about that. They are very holy, but it's something which is destroying your home. You like it. You see why people are cheating, because they don't have this lecture. You need information in each and every area which you don't know. Don't say you know. Or even the professors, they need information. So you need this information. As a wife, you must please your husband. Always love to kiss your husband. Husband, they like it. I study about husbands. They like it. They love it to be kissed with a wife. So if you say you don't want a kiss, or you say, yeah, your mouth is smelling, how can you say so to your husband? You don't like kissing. Please your husband. He wants to feel happy. If you don't do that, there are people who are ready for that. So which is not good, because cheating is bad. It will break your heart. So you as a wife, you don't have a power to your body. Are you exercising it? Are you practicing it? Practice it. Because a lot of people, they refuse about that. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. I'm not ready. Or just do that sex. Don't touch me. You don't know how to touch me. How can you say so? How can you say so? Be open and discuss about the romantic or romance. Discuss about your sexual life. That's why you are married. Discuss about your sexual life. What's going on? Are you happy? Am I satisfying you? Are you satisfied? Be open. Be open. You must have intimacy in sex also. Intimacy in sex. You see, God hates people or hates sexual immorality. This verse we read about sexual immorality. God hates that. God hates that. God hates that. Consult each other. Are you happy? Where must I correct? Number six, work out your character. Work out your character. The Bible did not say love your submissive wife. No. The Bible did not say love your submissive wife. The Bible did not say love your submissive, your cheerful husband. The Bible did not say love your cheerful wife. No. You must work out your character. Character is very important. If you say you want to marry, you have some character which you must drop, which your partner feel unhappy. You make your partner being unhappy. You must be ready to work out with your character. If you don't work it out with your character, it will cause divorce. Always, people will be unhappy because of character. Character is very important in marriage. You must be ready. Wherever your wife tells you that I don't like this character, your husband tells you I don't like this character, you must accept it. Accept it. Learn to accept. Don't defend it. Don't defend yourself. Or you think that you're always right. There's no one who is always right. Or there's no machine which is efficient, 100% efficient. I will say so. Or even a machine will go to a service. It will go to a what? To a service. So, work out your character. Character is very important. You are very rude. You are very rude. You are not impolite. Be polite. Be ready to drop your bad characters. Be ready to drop your what? Your bad characters. If you don't do that, it's a problem. It's a problem. Focus on your character in marriage. Whenever you see that your husband is not happy or your wife is not happy, focus on your character. Number seven, happiness is in understanding. When you don't understand, there is no happiness because you always do against. So you must understand each other. If you don't understand, it's a problem. Listen to understand. If you don't listen to understand, it's going to cause a problem. So if you don't focus on your character, happiness will not be there. Forget about happiness. Forget about happiness. Happiness is in you, two of you. If you know what your husband likes, and you know what your wife likes, it will cause happiness. It will be a joyous marriage. If you know that your husband doesn't like this, if you are being stubborn, you know, a wise woman build a home with her hands, but a foolish, she will destroy it with her own hands. Are you wise or you are foolish? Because if you say no, don't take advantage that your husband goes to church or your wife goes to church, then you take advantage of that. That's evil spirit. You don't have a mind which builds. You must have a mind which builds. Break yourself. Break yourself. Or you say, I just want him to be unhappy. That's an evil spirit. You make him mad. You make him mad. That's bad. To fix each other. Don't fix each other. We want happy marriages. Happy marriages is in understanding. Number eight, focus on God. Your marriage must be, Jesus must be your foundation. Must be your foundation. If you know that Jesus is your foundation, you won't struggle in your marriage. You won't struggle in your marriage. You will never ever struggle because you know that Jesus is your foundation. So who is your foundation in your marriage? God must be your foundation. If it is your foundation, you know that whatever you are doing, you represent Christ in marriage. Are you representing Christ, or you just make each other unhappy? You just make each other unhappy. You know, if you are not together, remember your wife, she can be hindered to your prayer or your husband. But the Bible said here, the one which we read, it said, your wife will be hindered to your what? To your prayer. These three verses, it said, husband likewise, dwell with them with understanding, giving honor to the wife as to weaker vessel. Remember that a wife is a weaker vessel, and it's being heirs together to the grace of life, that your prayers may not be hindered. So you must dwell with them to understand that your wife, your prayers will not be hindered. So be godly, a godly woman, a godly wife, a godly husband who fears God. Whatever you do, you must put God first. Whatever you do, put God first. Number 9. So always say, I love you. When you say, I love you, you say it with action. You don't just say, I love you with words. People who are married, they understand it now. The time you were single, spinster, a bachelor, you were just saying, I love you, but now you understand it. You love someone with your character. How do you love your wife? Or in words, yes, it's recommended that you must say, I love you. But your character, the way your wife dresses, it shows that you love her. The way you marry her, you are led by her. You know that. You must go and pay your baller, a dowry. You must go and pay. Yes, it's led by your labor and your wife. If you continue going and pay your lobola, it shows that you love your wife. You don't just say, I love you, you see, with your mouth. But your action speaks louder. The way you do, it speaks louder. Number 10, it's communication. How do you communicate? Always say, I love you, as we were talking about. Praise in public and correct it private. Praise in public and correct it in what? You can't nag in front of people, arguing and saying you don't think, reducing each other. Use a clean language, classic language, beautiful language. Unjust conflicts raise anger, unjust conflicts. So you don't even understand. You don't even understand. You see now. Because, so you must avoid problems with the way you talk to each other. You must. Don't reduce each other. You can't reduce your wife. Show your wife that you love your wife. Show your wife that I love you. And show her that you love her, and you go deeper in loving. So we must go deeper in practical what we are talking about. Don't make your marriage weaker. Don't make your marriage weaker. Everything is not going to. So it's about your character. If you don't work out with your character, which means you make your marriage weaker. So if you work out your marriage with your character, with whatever. And you drop all bad characters, which is your marriage, you are building your marriage. Everything is not going to be perfect always. No, this misunderstands. That's how a happy marriage comes. You start to disagree somewhere, but how you resolve the problem. You see, there are people, they start to accusing each other, accusation. Words that raise anger. Words that raise anger. Defile words. Words that defiles. Too much mouthing. You see, careless words, abundance of words, negative words, insult in front of people, blaming, peaceful. You must use a peaceful language. You must use a peaceful language, skillful in speaking. Be skillful in speaking. General in speech, be general. Don't raise your voice when you are at dialogue. Don't voice, raise your voice. Be general. And next door will hear that these people are shouting each other. Or maybe their action speaks louder than words. You can spend 1 week unhappy, don't even talk. Always you show that you are unhappy. A general speech. You must use a general speech. Don't use wrong words. You must use loving words. Loving words. It's not allowed in the rules of marriage to spend 1 week unhappy. So this message, I thank Lord that it will change your marriage. As long as you don't have a pride, you drop your pride. You drop everything. That bad character, it is going to build your marriage. So Jesus loves you. Your marriage must be under Christ, and Jesus Christ is your foundation. So Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. So stay blessed. Be blessed. Be in the word of God. You must have the fear of the Lord, and your marriage will be blessed. Whatever hindrance, whatever challenge you are facing, Jesus loves you. You are looking for what? What are you looking for? Why are you crying your marriage? You need Jesus. The intervention of Holy Ghost. The intervention of Jesus. As long as you have the word of God, you will have patience. Must have patience to each other in marriage. Thank you so much. Thank you.